It's time once again to welcome back our junior high correspondent, Katie Stanglin, after a month off, to bring us this extended look at Red Oak Junior High interview. Thanks for being here, Katie.
Thanks for having me, Rachel. Hello, Red Oak Junior High. Volleyball and football season have come to a close, and I've got those scores and other stories ahead. So go with me now as we take a closer look at the activities of November for Red Oak Junior High. As Hatted is one of the biggest clubs here at the junior high, the officers for the 2003-2004 year have just been chosen. President Kelsey Craig, Vice President Justin Lentz and Kiki Roberts, Secretary Taylor Ames, Treasurer Katie Major, Public Relations Jenna Davidson and India Fernandez, Junior High Reps to High School, CeCe Todd and Zach Ganoza, Director of Administration Taylor Parker, Chairman of the Board Jimmy Kohler, Board of Directors Dalton Thomas, Alexandria Marino, and Abby Smith. Hatted's first project was Red Ribbon Week, also known as Drug Free Week. This week is a time when students pledge to stand against alcohol and drugs and commit to being drug free. They kicked off this week by reading the pledge at the junior high football game, doing the national anthem, and releasing red balloons in honor of this week. We all need to step it up and take this pledge and live it. Pledge to be drug, alcohol, and smoke free. Volleyball has had a good season this year for 7th grade and 8th grade A and B teams. Congratulations, girls, you did a wonderful job, and I know the junior high is looking forward to having the 7th grade Lady Hawks back next year for another great season. In other Lady Hawks sports, the Lady Hawks basketball teams have just been chosen. Another congratulations goes out to these fantastic 7th and 8th grade talented athletes. I'm looking forward to reporting on your wins to come, and we'll report on boys basketball next month. We would also like to thank those wonderful Hawkett High Steppers for being so fantastic and performing at every pep rally and game this year. Also, we would like to thank the band for being so great as to come out to most of the football games and play to support our football team. Last but definitely not least, we have the 7th grade A team who we would like to congratulate on their outstanding season of being undefeated. These boys worked very hard and truly showed what team effort is. We'd like to welcome two special guests to Hawkeye News this month to bring us a wrap of the 2002 ROJH Christmas Toy Drive and to let us know what ROJH Hatted will be doing this year for the 2003 Toy Drive. This month, we welcome Katie and Haley Oliver, who are 8th graders at Red Oak Junior High and members of the ROJH Hatted. Welcome, ladies.
Hello, Red Oak. I hope we all had a very Merry Christmas last year and that we have an even better Christmas this year.
If you were in Red Oak Junior High Hatted last year, you know that some families would not have had such a great Christmas without the generosity of Red Oak Junior High students.
Last Christmas, Red Oak High School Hatted learned of several families needing assistance during the holiday season. So under the direction of Hatted sponsor, Sergeant Lori Williams, and Ms. Gretchen Ganoza, the call to help came out. The entire staff and student body kicked in and made Christmas for three families much better. In October 2002, tragedy struck the Marino family in Ferris. Mr. Marino was an innocent victim killed at a gas station in Ferris. Mrs. Marino works for ROISD and has three children. With the hard work of our Hatted group and the students of Red Oak Junior High, we were able to provide the family with gift certificates and toys.
In the same incident, Ferris police officer Marty Steinfeld was also killed. Marty's wife was pregnant at the time and was a Ferris school teacher. In our toy drive, we were able to provide baby gifts and gift certificates to help the new arrival. We also learned of the death of an Ellis County Sheriff's deputy who had left behind three small children that he was raising on his own. An older sister is caring for the young children now, and Red Oak Junior High Hatted was able to provide toys and gifts to each of them as well.
This year, we hope to be able to once again help those families in need with our 2003 Christmas toy drive.
We know that Red Oak High School Hatted will be hard at work doing the same, so we challenge all our junior high students to give to those in need, as we did last year, so that we can make the holidays brighter for families in need.
Wouldn't you like to touch someone's or some family's life like we were able to do last Christmas?
Then go ahead and sign up for Hatted now if you haven't already done so. And even if you are not in Hatted, still join us in donating new unwrapped toys or other money to this worthy cause. Well, Red Oak, we hope you all have a safe and happy holiday.
Thanks for inviting us on Hawkeye News. I'm Haley Oliver.
And I'm Katie Oliver. Merry Christmas.
Thank you, ladies, for being our special guests this month on Junior High in Review. That about does it for this month. Until next time.
Great job, Katie, and great job to all the awesome students at Red Oak Junior High.
Keep up the good work, and we will look forward to hearing more next month on Junior High in Review.